me cheaper while strengthening strategic geopolitical ties.
Tonight is going to be really good.
From royal descent in India to the shores of Australia.
Both mum and dad actually left and cut their ties to those royal heritages to come to Australia, more so because they wanted new beginnings. Mum wanted to travel the world and wanted to actually create a new life and pathway for me and my brother with all the opportunities that Australia presents.
On Tuesday, the Australian Bureau of Statistics released its latest population data based on country of birth. In 2021, 29% of Australian residents were born overseas, with English-born migrants accounting for the largest group. But the number of residents born in India saw the largest increase since 2011.
It's great to see that increasing trend, because in India, traditionally, when people thought of migration, especially skilled migration, they thought in terms of UK, US, Canada.
In 2018, an independent report to government recommended lifting India into Australia's top three export markets by 2035, labelling the logic behind a strategic investment in Australia's relationship with India as compelling.
There has been tensions that have been increasing with China. So to stabilise things around our region, Australia does need to form other partnerships. Economically, India is a growing market. It's one of the biggest economies, and it's going to become bigger and bigger, and huge middle class in India. It's a relatively young population. So all of that is going to create huge demand for Australian products and services.
Welcome to the signing ceremony.
At the start of April, more than a decade after negotiations began, an historic trade agreement was signed between Australia and India. It will see tariffs eliminated on more than 85% of Australian goods exported to India, rising to 90% over 10 years. A hot topic at a Global Leaders Forum in Sydney this week, hosted by the India-Australia Business and Community Alliance, an association forging networks between the two nations.
The brilliant minds are coming together at this event to ensure that we all are responsible and take ownership of driving this relationship forward. We're seeing a great trend where the Australian-Indian business diaspora is consistently becoming the top Australian-Indian exporter.
For Rishi, who has an accounting and finance background but used the pandemic to diversify, it's a golden opportunity to come full circle.
To change future generations of our family's history and to almost bring a piece of Australia back to India is something that the whole family is very proud of.
Tanya Dendrinos, SBS World News.